The Art of Psychological Warfare. Discover how to defend yourself from manipulation and learn dark techniques to mislead, intimidate, demoralize, and influence the thinking or behavior of your enemies. Written by Christopher Kingler, narrated by Russell Newton. Introduction. Psychological warfare is the use of propaganda and psychological manipulation to influence a target audience toward the accomplishment of a political, economic, or military goal. I'm severely saddened and a little bit disturbed that the United States of America, with all of its might, has used psychological warfare against its own people. This psychological warfare has been going on for so long that we, the people, have forgotten all about it and allowed it to continue. If a country was being used as a guinea pig in a psychological warfare experiment and the results were not favorable, the experiment would be discontinued. The question is this: are we the guinea pigs? I don't know, but upon researching the concept of psychological warfare, I've concluded, well, we sure might be. From the birth of the United States of America right up to the present day, we, the people, have been subjected to an ongoing psychological warfare program, and the war will never end. The war will never end because we are unaware of the full extent of the loss of freedom that has occurred and is still occurring. From my own investigations into the topic, I do not believe the psychological warfare program is only taking place in the United States, but also in other nations in the world. Secret documents have been leaked to an international news agency revealing that countries like Russia were also singled out for their participation in a psychological warfare program. I'm not making this up. I've read a ton of these leaked documents that a national news agency obtained from one of the countries being subjected to psychological warfare. Psychological warfare also happens in our ordinary lives. Those who practice psychology know it is possible to conduct surveillance on a person based on subtle clues provided by that person. A common example would be when someone is looking around at the paintings at a museum, and then later, that person gets hit by a spell that was cast against that person just because they looked at a bunch of paintings. As I said before, psychological warfare is nothing new. It was being practiced long before I was born, and I didn't grow up with a computer. But the computer sure made it 100 times easier to practice psychological warfare and made it harder to detect as well. We need to be aware that we have been heavily programmed by the government and television while we were in the womb. Yes, while we were in the womb. A major reason why it had to be done while we were in the womb is that we are all born with a superpower called intuition. The government and television program people in that area of the brain the least because that is where people are stronger than them. The rest of the brain has been hard at work since before we were born. This psychological warfare program is used in all of society's sectors. An example would be in the media. Investigative journalism has been around a long time, but recently, a lot of investigative journalists have been silenced because of the psychological warfare program. The reason behind the attack on the media is that the psychological warfare program is nothing more than an attempt to sustain the illusion of a strong, powerful, invincible USA. I've also researched the Pentagon and have read about a few situations where they've acted out psychological warfare programs by using the services of individuals who have been trained in the art of covert warfare. I'll not go into the process of the psychological warfare program in any great detail, as I'm a writer, not a trained psychologist. However, this book will cover the various branches of psychological warfare. This is so you will be aware of the truth and be able to avoid psychological warfare programs, thus reducing any damage that they may cause you. It's up to you to decide what to do with this information, whether you will simply ignore it or whether you will react to it positively and vigorously. The psychological warfare program, though it is a covert program, is not a secret to journalists. While people like ourselves may feel naive about some of the things we've heard and read regarding psychological warfare, spies think about us. Hey, we all know about you. I've met with many reporters who have covered the psychological warfare program, and none of them are aware of any of this information. You'd be surprised by the number of people who are aware of this information, and they only talk to other individuals who are already aware of it. They don't talk about it to the public. Be aware that the psychological warfare program is always just around the corner. Nothing can be taken for granted. I'm of the opinion that the psychological warfare program is being carried out by people in our own government. These people are professionals in covert warfare, and they are professionals in psychological warfare as well. It's up to you to decide what you'll do about the psychological warfare program. React positively or react negatively. How you choose to react will have an effect on your life and the fate of your loved ones, so to speak. The psychological warfare program is so subtle that it is virtually impossible to avoid. Even the most experienced and dedicated truth seekers may still be subjected to the psychological warfare program. There is one thing I do know. Our only hope is that we can change the way we react to things for the better. It's our duty to make positive changes in our lives. Create change. Chapter 1. Why You Should Know the Art of Psychological Warfare. All people have a dark side. Some people just suppress that side and don't explore all the power it has to offer. You, on the other hand, have decided to explore and even enrich your dark side. Many benefits await you. Human beings are naturally ruthless and competitive creatures. The only ones who succeed are people who are willing to violate morals and ethics to get to the top. Now that you've decided to do this, you will get to the top too. You'll only fall behind and lose in life if you don't become cutthroat and shameless about going after what you want. But in our society, we have to at least pretend to follow the current social code of morals and ethics. Otherwise, people will judge us harshly and avoid us. They won't be as willing to like you and to help you out. Your psychological warfare training will not work if people start to dislike you and avoid you. Therefore, you must create a facade that totally obscures your dark side. You must hide behind an elaborate and beautiful facade that fools people into liking and trusting you. It's the only way to get away with psychological warfare. Create a foolproof facade. So, how do you create this lovely, warming facade that fools the world? How should you look to others? How do you hide what you're really up to? How do you make people believe that you mean only the best and that you're not ruthless and self-serving? Well, deception is part of it, but so is denial, and so is confidence. You can create a very convincing facade if you blend these three elements into your outward projection of yourself. You'll create a facade so convincing that you will have everyone fooled. Deception. It's okay to lie about yourself and present yourself deceptively if it builds your image. You can use deception to make yourself look good to others. Just make sure that your lies are not blatant. You want to mislead people by making yourself look good, but you don't want to lie and look pathetic should you get found out. Always tell at least most of the truth when you talk about yourself. Let's say you're on a date. You want to make the best impression, but you don't have a great job. You don't want to lie outright about your job as you might get caught. Instead, talk up your job and use words that exaggerate the importance of your position. Focus on your strengths when you speak about yourself, too. Try to show off your strengths. Don't show off your weaknesses. Downplay your weaknesses to make yourself look better. The better your outward image is, and the more positive of a character you appear to have, the more people will like you. Then, you will have better luck with people. Denial. Denial can help you appear innocent. There are many aspects to denial. You should combine deception and denial in order to fool people into thinking that you are incapable of wrongdoing. The victim card is a good one to play. deny that you've ever done wrong, and pretend to be an innocent victim.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.